Swedish singer-songwriter based in New York City. Thank you so much, Meth Boy, for finding my music and for putting me on your music chart. So now I'm number one. It feels really, really great. Thanks so much for those of you who voted for me, and thanks for putting me on the chart in the first place. I came here 4 years ago to study an exchange from the Royal Academy of Fine Arts in Denmark. So I have my education within fine arts, but I've been playing music since I was a kid. I got my first piano when I was 6 years old. And since then, we've just been friends, and I've been writing songs since I was about 8 years old. Always in English for some reason, even though my mother tongue is Danish. I love writing music. I can't live without doing that. It's really, really important for me. Since I graduated from the Art Academy in Denmark, I've been making a lot of music and visual art as well, and in the end of my education I started interacting the two, so now I have a sound and visual practice. So if you come to my performances, you'll see both aspects being present. Sometimes I perform at just like you know, music venues, sometimes at galleries. I've even performed at a museum in Norway. I get my inspiration from the people around me and the places I travel to. These days I get most of my inspiration from my family and friends and from the streets of New York. Is a song about the spring, so it's actually pretty perfect. It made number one right now, where it's spring 2016. It came out of a pretty intense time in my life. I was struggling a lot with some issues, and Butterflies is a song about hope and about growing through struggles and about getting through the struggles and coming out on the other side. So spring for me is a symbol of inspiration and of blooming and getting back on track. I write all my songs myself. I make all the music for my songs as well. On this specific album, I have been working very closely with Seth Mysterka, also called Seth Digital. He is in a band called Dynasty Electric, and he's a really great producer and a close friend of mine. It's been so amazing working with him on these songs. Butterfly specifically, though, was made together with producers Lauren Serra and Ben Amena from Races Productions. So I came up to them with my song and we spoke about what my idea was with the song, and they helped me create the soundscape around it. For my next album though, I'd really love to produce everything myself, so let's see if that dream will come true. In the pop industry that I really respect would be people like Mark Ronson and Pharrell Williams, and also Michel Gondry makes the most amazing music videos. I really dream about one day meeting him and perhaps collaborating. Other artists I really would love to collaborate with would be, I guess, some kind of like really old school like folk artists like Tom Waits or Patti Smith or some of the real dynamite. Too much strength to keep going. I can't function without making music, so it's just in my veins. I don't need strength to keep going. It just comes out. I need strength to kind of close it up at times. what I am struggling with the most is, I guess, doing PR for myself.
See the angels protecting her.
It's a new world, the music industry is really interesting. It's also very untransparent and in constant flux, so it's really interesting to try to navigate through through the structures there. I mean, it's difficult to say what to change in the industry because it's developing so fast. One thing I think is problematic within the music industry is that it's so difficult to actually make money as an independent artist. All of the social media platforms are amazing and it gives so much more opportunity than what I've been before. However, platforms like Spotify and Tidal and iTunes, they're really great. They give a lot of opportunities and a lot of exposure, but at the same time, it's really difficult making money out of that exposure. So I think it would be really great to see some changes that were like would not leave us with the constant question, when will we get paid? In the industry who have had extremely bad experiences with being signed by labels and who have been forced to do different commercial work that they didn't associate with and without even getting paid because they had to pay all the, they had to drag and pull in money to pay back the money that the labels had invested in their career. So I'm not super interested in being signed, but yeah, I think I have at least most of the qualities I need myself to make it, but it would definitely be really, really nice to have somebody to organize everything around the music. I guess I'll try my own way until something really interesting comes my way. If I was to work with a label, I would really like to see it as a collaboration instead of me being signed in a way where I had to work for them. So if I could find some kind of partnership with another label, that would be really amazing. Thank you so much for putting me on the list, and thanks for reaching out. Thank you so much for following up on me with this interview, and thanks for your interest in my music. I really appreciate it. It's amazing. Thanks.